Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecture 6 of module 5 linear algebra. In the last lecture we have seen how to find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a given matrix. So in this lecture first we will study about an iterative method called Rayleigh's power method, and using this method we can find the numerically largest eigenvalue for a given matrix. So first of all let us recall the definition of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Now given a matrix A, scalar lambda is called eigenvalue of A if there exists a non-zero column matrix X such that Ax equal to lambda X. Here this X is called, non-zero vector X is called the eigenvector of matrix A. Now given a matrix, so in this method, power method, we assume that X naught is the initial eigenvector, and then we'll find the matrix product A into X naught. Then A into X naught will also be a column matrix. A into X naught will also be a column matrix. From this column matrix we take out the numerically largest element as the common factor and write it in the form lambda 1 x1. So here lambda 1 is the first approximation of the eigenvalue and x1 is the corresponding eigenvector. We then compute A into x1, the product A into x1, and we write it in the form lambda 2 x2, where lambda 2 is the second approximation of the eigenvalue and x2 is the corresponding eigenvector. This iterative process is continued till the difference between two consecutive eigenvectors becomes negligible. Let us start with the first example. Find the largest eigenvalue and the corresponding eigenvector of the matrix A is equal to 201 020 102 by power method. Taking initial eigenvector x0 is equal to 100, carry out 4 iterations. So here we are given the square matrix of order 3 and we need to find the largest eigenvalue and corresponding eigenvector, and also given that initial eigenvector is x0 is equal to 100. So we will take A and then multiply A with the x0. So this A is a 3 by 3 matrix and x0 is a 3 by 1 matrix. So the resultant matrix will be of order 3 by 1. That is, there will be 3 rows and 1 column. So I multiply the first row with this column. So 2 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 0. It is 2. Next, I multiply the second row here with this column. So 0 into 1 plus 2 into 0 plus 0 into 0 is 0. Then last row multiply with this column. 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 2 into 0. It is 1. Then we need to take the numerically largest value outside this matrix. Here numerically largest value is 2. So we take it outside and divide each entry or each element here by 2. So we get the matrix. So 2 by 2, 1. Then we have 0 by 2, 0. Then we have 1 by 2, or we can write it in the form 0.5. Then we call it as lambda 1 x1. So lambda 1 is 2 and x1 is 100.5. So next step, we multiply A with this x1 and find the matrix product. So A into x1, this a into x1. So again multiply, so the 3 cross 1 matrix, so it is the first entry is 2 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 0.5, so it is 2.5. next we have 0 into 1 plus 2 into 0 plus 0 into 0.5, 0. next 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 2 into 0.5, we have 2. Now numerically largest value is 2.5. take it outside and divide each entry by 2.5. so we have 2.5 taken outside. 2.5 by 2.5 is 1, 0 by 2.5 is 0, then you have 2 by 2.5 is 0.8. call it as lambda 2 x2. So in the next step we multiply a with this x2. Find the matrix product a x2. So substitute for a and x2. So 2 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 0.8, it is 2.8. first entry. Next we have 0 into 1 plus 2 into 0 plus 0 into 0.8, 0. then 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 2 into 0.8, 2.6. take 2.8 outside the column. So divide each entry by 2.8. so we have 1, 0 and 2.6 by 2.8 is 0.93. call it as lambda 3 x3. okay, and in the question they were asked to carry out 4 iterations. So we have ax0 first iteration, then ax1 second iteration, this is third iteration ax2. So one more iteration we need to perform. So find ax3, a into x3. So 1, 2 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 1 into 0.93, we have 2.93. then we have 0 into 1 plus 2 into 0 plus 0.93 is 0. then 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 2 into 0.93 is 2.86. so take 2.93 outside the matrix, divide by 2.93, we get 10.98. okay, so this is our lambda 4 x4. So after the fourth iteration we have the eigenvalue of the matrix is 2.93. the largest eigenvalue is 2.93 and the corresponding eigenvector is column matrix 10.98. so the largest eigenvalue is 2.93, the corresponding eigenvector is 10.98, this row matrix transpose. Next question, find the dominant eigenvalue and the corresponding eigenvector of the matrix A is equal to 161 120 003 by power method, taking initial eigenvector x0 is equal to 100. So here dominant eigenvalue is nothing but the largest eigenvalue. So we need to find the largest eigenvalue and the corresponding eigenvector for the given matrix. So start with the ax0, substitute for a and x0 and find the matrix product. We'll have 1 into 1 plus 6 into 0 plus 1 into 0, it is 1. Then you have 1 into 1 plus 2 into 0 plus 0 into 0 is 1. Then 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 3 into 0 is 0. So here in this matrix, column matrix, numerically largest value is 1. Take it outside the matrix, we can write it as 1 into 1, column matrix 110, or we can write it in the form lambda 1 x1. Then we find ax1, a into x1, x1 is this 110. Find the product 1 into 1 plus 6 into 1 plus 1 into 0, it is 7. Then we have 1 into 1 plus 2 into 1 plus 0 into 0, 3. 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 plus 3 into 0 is 0. So here 7 is numerically largest, take it outside the column matrix, we get 7 into 7 by 7 1. Then we have 3 by 7 0.43, 0 by 7 is 0. Call it as lambda 2 x2 and then perform ax2, find ax2 and we'll get the product. So 1 into 1 plus 6 into 0.43 plus 1 into 0 is 3.57. 1 into 1 plus 2 into 0.43 plus 0 into 0 is 1.86. 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0.43 plus 3 into 0 is 0. 3.57, numerical largest, take it outside the matrix. So 3.57 by 1, 3.57 is 1. 1.86 by 3.57 is 0.52. Then 0 by 3.57, 0. Call it as lambda 3 x3. Okay, continue this. Find ax3. So we'll get this product 4.12 2.040, and take 4.12 numerical largest, take it outside the matrix. So 4.12 by 4.12 is 1, then 2.04 by 4.12 is 0.5, then 0 by 4.12 is 0. Call it as lambda 4 x4. Okay, let's continue. So find ax4. Okay, find the product. We will get 4 2 0. Take 4 outside the matrix, we'll get 4 by 4 1, 2 by 4.5, 0 by 4 is 0. Now call it as lambda 5 x5. And here we can observe that two values, so consecutive values, that is x4 and x5 are equal. So we can stop the process. Okay, and we can say that this 4 is the largest eigenvalue, and this column matrix 1.50 is the corresponding eigenvector. Next problem, find the largest eigenvalue and corresponding eigenvector of the matrix A is equal to 2 -1 0 -1 2 -1 0 -1 2 by power method. So here note that initial vector is not given. So initial vector x0, we can take it as column matrix 100 or 010 or 001, or we can take 111 or anything, but usually we take, if not given, take it as 100. So x0 100 be the initial eigenvector, and find the product a into x0. So a into x0, 2 into 1 plus 0 plus 0, that is 2. Then we have minus 1 into 1, minus 1 plus 0 plus 0, that is minus 1. 0 into 1, 0. Minus 1 into 0, 0. 2 into 0, 0. So we get this numerical largest is 2. Take it outside the matrix. So 2 by 2, 1. Minus 1 by 2 is minus 0.5. 0 by 2 is 0. Call it as lambda 1 x1. Next, find ax1 similarly. Okay, substitute for a and this is x1, and find the product 2 into 1 plus minus 1 into minus 0.5 plus 0 into 0, we'll get 2.5. okay, next we have minus 1 1 minus 1 into 1 plus 2 into minus 0.5 plus minus 1 into 0. Use calculator and find the value, we'll get minus 2. And 0 into 1 plus minus 1 into minus 0.5 plus 2 into 0, it is 0.5. numerically largest 2.5, take it outside. 2.5, 2.5 by 2.5 is 1, minus 2 by 2.5 is minus 0.8, 0.5 by 2.5 is 0.2. So we call it as lambda 2 x2. Okay, so continue this process. So find ax2, we'll get this. Okay, here numerical largest, we can take 2.8 outside the matrix. So we'll get this lambda 3 x3. Call it as lambda 3 x3. Find ax3, a into x3, and we'll get this matrix. So 2 into 1 plus minus 1 into minus 1 plus 0 into 0.43 is 3. Then minus 1 into 1 plus 2 into minus 1 plus minus 1 into 0.43 is minus 3.43. And 0 into 1 plus minus 1 into minus 1 plus 2 into 0.43 is 1.86. Now here, just take numerically largest element outside the matrix. So note this. Here if you numerically largest means you have to just ignore the sign and look at the element. So if we ignore the sign, we have numerically largest, we have 3.43. Take it outside the matrix. So 3.43. So divide each entry by 3.43. So 3 by 3.43 is 0.87. Minus 3.43 by 3.43 is minus 1. 1.86 by 3.43 is 0.54. So call it as lambda 4 x4. Okay, find ax4. a into this x4. Find the product, use the calculator and find this 2 into 0.87 plus minus 1 into minus 1 is 2.74. Like next, minus 1 into 0.87, 2 into minus 1 plus minus 1 into 0.54 is minus 3.41. Then 0 into 0.7 plus minus 1 into minus 1 plus 2 into 0.54 is 2.08. Here numerically largest is 3.41. Take it outside and 2.74 by 3.41 is 0.8. Minus 3.41 by 3.41 is minus 1. 2.08 by 3.41 is 0.61. Call it as lambda 5 x 5. Next we have a into x 5. Find this product a into x 5. So a into x 5, so we have 2 into 0.8 plus minus 1 into minus 1 plus 0 into 0.61 is equal to 2.6. minus 1 into 0.8 plus 2 into minus 1 plus minus 1 into 0.61 is equal to minus 3.41. then 0 into 0.8 plus minus 1 into minus 1 plus 2 into 0.61 is 2.22. take 3.41 outside the matrix. So we have 2.6 by 3.41 is 0.76. Then we have this minus 3.41 by 3.41 is minus 1. 2.22 by 3.41 is 0.65. Call it as lambda 6 and x 6. And here we can see that these two consecutive eigenvalues, we have same eigenvalues 3.41, and this difference, if you look at x5 and x6, they are approximately equal. The difference between them is negligible, so we can stop the process. So the required eigenvalue is, the largest eigenvalue is this 3.41, and the corresponding eigenvector is column matrix 0.76 minus 1.65. Next problem, we have find the largest eigenvalue and the corresponding eigenvector of the matrix by power method, given A is equal to 6 minus 2 2 minus 2 3 minus 1 2 minus 1 3, and the initial eigenvector x0 is equal to 1 0 1. So find the product A into x0, A into given x0. So 6 into 1 plus 0, minus 2 into 0 plus 2 into 1, it is 8. Next we have minus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 0 plus minus 1 into 1 is minus 3. Then 2 into 1 plus minus 1 into 0 plus 3 into 1 is 5. So here numerically largest element is 8. Take it outside the matrix. 8 by 8 1, 3 by 8 minus 3 by 8 is minus 0.38, and 5 by 8 is 0.63. Call it as lambda 1 x 1. Then find a into this x 1. Find the product, substitute for a and x 1. Find the product. So first row, first column, second row, this column, third row, this column. Find the three entries. 8.02 is the largest, numerically largest. Take it outside the matrix, so we'll get 8.02 outside, taken outside, 1 here. Minus 3.77 by 8.02 is minus 0.47. 4.27 by 8.02 is 0.53. Okay, we call it as lambda 2 x2, and find a into x2. So we get a into x2. Find this product, we'll get 8 minus 3.94, 4.06. 8 is the largest, take it outside, we'll get 1 minus 0.49, 0.51, that is lambda 3 x3. So here the difference is still there, so we just continue and find a x3. So we'll get a x3 equal to A into x3 equal to this column matrix, 8 numerical largest, take it outside, we'll get lambda 4, call it as lambda 4 x4, and A into x4 is, A into this x4 is 8 minus 4 4, 8 taken outside, 8 by 8 is 1, minus 4 by 8 is minus 0.5, 4 by 8 is 0.5, call it as lambda 5 x5. And here note that these two are exactly same, x4 and x5 are same. So the largest eigenvalue is this 8, and the corresponding eigenvector is the column matrix 1 minus 0.5 0.5. okay, this one 1 minus 0.5 0.5, it's transpose. Next topic we are going to discuss in this lecture is diagonalization of a matrix. So what is diagonalization of a matrix? Before we discuss it, let's go through this definition. A square matrix A of order n is called similar to a square matrix B of order n if B is equal to P inverse AP for some non-singular matrix P of order n. Now, a square matrix A is said to be diagonalizable if there exists a non-singular matrix P such that P inverse AP is a diagonal matrix. So we have the definition of diagonalizable matrix is this. A square matrix A is said to be diagonalizable if there exists a non-singular matrix P such that P inverse AP is a diagonal matrix. So here, by using this definition of similar matrices, we can also say that a matrix is said to be diagonalizable if A is similar to a diagonal matrix. Using this, because P inverse AP is equal to a diagonal matrix, so that we can say that A is similar to a diagonal matrix. Now consider a matrix, square matrix of order n. Now there is a result which says that this matrix A is diagonalizable if matrix A has n linearly independent eigenvectors. Okay, so suppose we take the second order matrix A. Okay, it has then two eigenvalues lambda 1, lambda 2, and this vector column matrix x1, y1. Suppose this is the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda 1, and this column matrix x2, y2 be the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda 2. Now, we form a matrix capital P is equal to this x1, x2, y1, y2. That is, columns of P are the eigenvectors corresponding to different eigenvalues. So here we have x1, y1, the first eigenvector, and x2, y2, the second eigenvector. Next, if you calculate P inverse into A into P, we can check that this is nothing but D, diagonal matrix lambda 1, 0, 0, lambda 2. That is, the diagonal entries of diagonal matrix is nothing but the two eigenvalues of matrix C. Note that the matrix P which diagonalizes A is called the model matrix of A, and D is called the diagonal matrix D is called the spectral matrix of A. Now, one of the applications of diagonalization is that we can easily compute the power of matrices once we can diagonalize the matrix. So we have seen that if A can be diagonalized, then we can write P inverse AP equal to D. And if we pre-multiply and by P here, we get P inverse AP equal to PD. And if we use the result P inverse or P inverse equal to identity matrix, then we get AP equal to PD. And then if we multiply P inverse, we'll get on both sides. If we multiply by P inverse, we get AP P inverse equal to PD P inverse, or A is equal to PD P inverse. If you want to find A bar n, then we multiply this A n times, and using associative property and taking P inverse P equal to identity matrix, we'll have P D etc. n times. D is multiplied n times here, P inverse, or we have P D power n P inverse. So A power n equals to P into D power n into P inverse. So we can use this as a formula for computation of very high power of matrix A. This result is useful because D to the power n computation is very easy compared to a power n computation. So if d is equal to lambda 1 0 0 lambda 2, we have diagonal matrix d lambda 1 0 0 lambda 2, then d power n is lambda 1 0 0 lambda 2 power n, and we can write for a diagonal matrix nth power of diagonal matrix is nothing but in the diagonally you have to take nth powers of the elements. So it is lambda 1 power n 0 0 lambda 2 power n. We can find it very easily. But now let's consider this example. Diagonalize the matrix A is equal to 3 1 2 4 and hence find A power 4. We have already seen the method for computing the eigenvalues in the previous lecture. So how do you find the eigenvalues of this matrix A? So we first write down the characteristic equation for the matrix and we solve it. So the characteristic equation is determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. That is, substituting for A and I, we get 3 minus lambda 1, 2, 4 minus lambda I equal to 0. Or we can write, this characteristic equation is lambda square minus principal diagonal elements lambda plus determinant of A equal to 0. That is lambda square minus 3 plus 4 lambda plus determinant of A. What is determinant of A? 3 into 4 minus 1 into 2, that is 10. So we can write lambda square minus 7 lambda plus 10 equal to 0. Next we solve this equation, we will get two roots. Roots are 2 and 5, and these are nothing but the eigenvalues of the matrix. Next we find the eigenvectors corresponding to each of these eigenvalues. So for that we need to consider the homogeneous system of equations matrix A minus lambda I x equal to 0. Now what is A minus lambda I? We have here this matrix. So substituting, and capital X is the column matrix with the x, y as entries. So first first equation will be 3 minus lambda x plus y equal to 0. Second equation is 2x plus 4 minus lambda y equal to 0. Next we take the first eigenvalue lambda equal to 2, here we get the first eigenvector. Then we take lambda equal to 5, we'll get the second eigenvector. So taking lambda equal to 2, the first equation 3 minus 2x plus y equal to 0, or we can write x plus y equal to 0. The second equation will be 2x plus 2y equal to 0. So here note that these two equations are one and the same. So solving, we get y equal to minus x. So the first eigenvector is capital X1 is putting x equal to small x equal to 1, we get y equal to minus 1. So this column matrix, this is the first eigenvector or eigenvector corresponding to the first eigenvalue lambda equal to 2. Next we will find eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 5. So take lambda equal to 5 here, 3 minus 5 x plus y equal to 0, or minus 2 x plus 5 plus y equal to 0. The second equation becomes taking lambda equal to 5, 2x minus y equal to 0, or y equal to 2x we have. So the eigenvector is capital X2 is minus small x is 1, y is 2. So x2 is 1, 2. This column matrix, this is the eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 5. So eigenvalues are 2 and 5, and these two are the corresponding eigenvectors. Next, we form a matrix or a model matrix P with these two eigenvectors as the columns of the matrix. So here we have model matrix P is equal to 1, 1, minus 1, 2. Note this, this is the first eigenvector of the matrix, and 1, 2, this is the second eigenvector of the matrix. Next, we find inverse of the matrix, this matrix P, that is P inverse, by using the formula P inverse equal to 1 by determinant of P into adjoint of P. Now, what is determinant of P? 1 into 2 minus 1 into minus 1. We have determinant of P is 3. And how do you get the adjoint of P for a second order matrix? We just interchange the main diagonal elements and change the sign of the remaining elements. That is, adjoint of P is 2, 1, and minus 1 here, minus 1, 1. So next, find P inverse AP equal to D. So D will get diagonal matrix. Substitute for P inverse here and A given matrix, and p. So in the next step, 1 by 3, 2 minus 1, 1, 1 keep as it is. Find the product of these two matrices. So we'll get this into 3 into 1 plus 1 into minus 1. It is 2. 3 into 1 plus 1 into 2 is 5. Then we have 2 into 1 plus 4 into minus 1 is minus 2, and 2 into 1 plus 4 into 2 is 10. So next step, 1 by 3 into, multiply these two, 2 into 2 plus minus 1 into minus 2 is 6, 2 into 5 plus minus 1 into 10 is 0, 1 into 2 plus 1 into minus 2 is 0, then 1 into 5 plus 1 into 10 is 15. So next step, divide each entry by 3 here, so we will get matrix 2, 0, 0, 5, diagonal matrix, and note that the main diagonal elements are nothing but the eigenvalues of the matrix A. So next we find a power 4 by using this formula, a power n equal to p d power n p inverse. So a power 4 is p d power 4 p inverse. Now substitute for d power 4 p and p inverse. What is d? D is the diagonal matrix 2 0 0 5. So d power 4 is to find the power d power 4. So we just need to find 2 power 4 0 0 5 power 4, which is 16 0 0 6 25, and then multiply these three. So p d power 4 and p inverse. So 1 by 3 into 1 1 minus 1 2, multiply these two. 16 into 2 plus 0 into 1 32, 16 into minus 1 plus 0 into 1 is minus 16, 0 into 2 plus 625 into 1 is 625, 0 into minus 1 plus 625 into 1 is 625. So next step, we multiply these two. So 1 by 3 into 1 into 32 plus 1 into 625 is 657, 1 into minus 16 plus 1 into 625 is 609. Then we have minus 1 into 32 plus 2 into 625 is 1218, minus 1 into minus 16 plus 2 into 625 is 1266. Divide each entry by 3, we get 219, 203, 406 and 422. So this is the required matrix A power 4. Next problem, reduce the matrix minus 19, 7, minus 42, 16 to the diagonal form. So here, to diagonalize the matrix, first name the matrix as A and then find the eigenvalues by finding the roots of characteristic equation, determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. We have determinant of A minus lambda is minus 19 minus lambda, 7 minus 42, 16 minus lambda equal to 0. That is, we can write lambda square minus minus 19 plus 16 lambda plus determinant of A equal to 0, or lambda square plus 3 lambda minus 10 equal to 0. Here minus 10 is the determinant of A, minus 19 into 16 minus 7 into minus 42, we get to minus 10. So then solve this equation, we get two roots, 2 and minus 5. These are the two eigenvalues of the characteristic, the given matrix. So find the eigenvectors corresponding to these two eigenvalues by writing the homogeneous equations A minus lambda I x equal to 0. That is, the first equation is minus 19 minus lambda x plus 7 y equal to 0, and the second equation is minus 42 x plus 16 minus lambda y equal to 0. So put lambda equal to 2, we'll get the first eigenvector. Then take lambda equal to minus 5 here and solve the equations, we'll get the second eigenvector. So taking lambda equal to 2, we get these two equations, and which gives 21x equal to 7y or y equal to 3x. So the first eigenvector is x1 is equal to, when x is 1, y is 3, and second vector, to find the second eigenvector, take lambda equal to 2 in the homogeneous system of equations, we get minus 14x plus 7y equal to 0, and the second equation will be minus 42x plus 21y equal to 0. These two equations are one and the same, we can solve for x and y here. So we can write from the equations we can write 14x equal to 7y or y equal to 2x. Then eigenvector is taking x equal to 1, we have y, we have 2 from this. So x2 is 1, 2. Next form the model matrix capital P with the, these two eigenvectors as the columns. So first column of the model matrix P is 1, 3. Second column is 1, 2. Then find P inverse. Formula is 1 by P inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of P adjoint of into adjoint of P. What is the determinant of P? It is 1 into 2 minus 1 into 3, that is minus 1. So the adjoint of P can be obtained by interchanging the main diagonal elements and changing the signs of the other two elements, that is here 2, 1 and minus 1, minus 3. Then divide by minus 1, we get minus 2, 1, 3, minus 1. So P inverse is this. Then find the product P inverse into A into P. We get the diagonal matrix. So diagonal matrix D is equal to P inverse AP. Substitute for P inverse A and P. So minus 2, 1, 3 into minus 1. Keep as it is. Find the product of these two matrices first and multiply with this. And then find the product of these two matrices. We will get 2, 0, 0, minus 5. So this is the required diagonal matrix. And here the eigenvalues, we can see here the eigenvalues 2 and minus 5 are the diagonal entries of the diagonal matrix. So we have seen in this lecture how to find the largest eigenvalue using power method, and we have also seen how to reduce a given square matrix to a diagonal matrix. Thank you.